Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create a complex wall design in Revit. As you can see on my screen here, we got some photo reference or project reference before we jumping into our project. And if I zoom in closely, you will saw my complex wall design here. It's a complex wall design combination with our wood construction. And when I turn on to another panel for bedroom A sunside, you will saw some view from for our bedroom here. If I turn on to another bedroom C view here, you can see the whole panel here. And of course, I will give you a quick instruction and a concept to create those kind of wall design. And after you got all the concept there, you can create some kind of concept for any wall design complex shape in Revit. Okay, so before I get started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out to my channel or visiting to my channel and you want to learn more about Revit, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for all notification for learn more about Revit. Okay, I think it's pretty much and you got saw my project review already. Let's speak into our project together. I'm going to our file there as away, then simply create new, then family tie here, and of course go to English for metric. Basically in our family here, to create this kind of panel here, you got many different options for create that. In some cases, you can using for metric curtain wall panel for a parametric, or you can using for window to create those kind of panel also. But in this case there, I prefer using for metric generate model. It's a faster way for me. Then I can open up for metric generate model. After that, Revit will transfer me to another page. Okay, as you can see, I am in generate model. What I'm going to do next, I'm going to close some window first because I don't want to open it too much. Then go to our front view. It's time to draw our model. I'm going to our create tab using our extrusion. Simply start for our rectangle, start pop up something here and adjustment our size here. I'm going to make it square, hit escape. And of course I need to offset about 30 millimeter for thickness. Then hit a tab key for change our direction. As you can see here, line direction, hit a escape, use our arch here. Make sure you change our offset to zero. Then I simply start from here and something like this and another guy there. Let's make it something like this. Hit a escape, SL for select element. I'm going to select our element TR for trim, then I'm going to trim here. Then of course I need to assign a new associate family parameter as well. Then I'm going to make it about for rename it, just rename it for wood panel. Then I just hit OK. Go to our family type because I want to assign for new material now. Then create new. We just simply rename it for wood panel. Simply go to our apparent library, access browser, apparent library again, wood. I prefer using for bird. Then hit apply, it's okay. Apply, it's okay. Before I hit finish up my panel, I need to change our extrusion and first I will make it for 30 millimeter for thickness. Then I can apply, hit finish. Okay, once you done your first panel, it's time to create another panel. Create tab again, extrusion, then rectangle. Start from here and make it for 400 millimeter. Hit escape, offset for 30 again. Then start from here, hit a space key. Perfect. Use our arch here. Make it for zero and simply start from here. Like this and make here something like this. I think there I need to adjustment first. Okay, I want some shape like this. Then I need to offset for 30 millimeter for offset. Okay, I think something like this. going to let me check first. Okay, something like this, and I need to connect here as well, and here I need to connect also. Okay, then there we need to connect also before we split our element. Then we just move it down a bit. Okay, perfect. Again, our arch here, I'm going to create another one. Just make it something like this. You just pre-draw here actually SL for split element. TR for trim. Okay, sorry. I need to control Z first. TR. Okay, here delete and assign new material as already. Then I think everything is perfect. We just hit finish up. And again, I need to create our third panel. Just follow our previous instruction. Okay, and then let me create another step first. Just our arts here, then simply start from here. SL for split element again, TR for trim and extend. Okay, because there we haven't split yet, so I need to split all first before I finish our project here. TR for trim and extend. Okay, these two guys there we need to delete. DE for shortcut key. Okay, I think it's perfect. We just hit finish up. Okay, so now we got three panel here. What we are going to do next, I'm going to move our elements same position first. V for shortcut key. Then hit escape, go to our reference plane. And I simply move it here. Just move it out first. Then hit escape a couple times, and of course I'm going to our front again, then go to our create tab, extrusion again, then I'm going to start from here like this, then offset for 10 mm, hit escape, and of course I need to change another material type as well. Create new material, make it for Y. It's okay. Go to our family and make this change our material type first. Create new material type, rename it for Y. Appearance library. Like this. Apply, it's okay. It's apply, then it's finished. Then it finished again. Okay, go to our 3D here. And here I need to extend first. Okay, as you can see, we got some complex shape here. If I turn on for real estate, as you can see, it's quite interesting. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to open up another project, Control N for shortcut key, matrix architecture template. Then Revit will transfer me to another template for Revit architecture template. Then I'm going back to my 3D here. Then simply load into our project. Project save is okay. Then simply press here, hit escape first, select my panel here, AR for array, start array from here until here. Then I'm going to type it for 10. Then hit escape first, go to our sound elevation here. Then I'm going to move all of them down first. Select one of my panel, SA for select all element, then UG for ungroup all, then MV again for move command. Okay, I think you got learned some a lot of shortcut key when you watch my tutorial. And again, AR for array, start from our first point here, then until second point here. Then of course I need to tie it to we consider tie it for 10 or so, make it more higher. Okay, 10 is too high, make it to 8. Hit escape a couple of time. Let's go to our 3D default here. Then when I turn on for realistic, let me turn on for realistic first. Okay, as you can see, we got quite complex shape, but actually for our white color here, you can make it more thicker than that because it's too thin already. As you can see here, it's a complex shape one. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. As you can see on our project reference there, I hope you got some learn something new about that. And thank you guys for joining me from start to finish, and make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for all notification if you want to learn more about Revit so you won't miss my future tutorial. Don't forget to thumbs up, like and share for the tutorial. Thank you for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice weekend. Thank you.